Hello everyone, ConceptGraph 0.5 was just released, and if you wanna try it, GitHub link is down below in the description. The tool evolved a lot over the last month, the amount of commit almost doubled, so I'm working on a video tutorial that's more up to date. However, I also want to improve the example scenes provided, and I would like to know your thoughts on what should be there, what kind of example you need, and how complex they should be. Let me know what you want down below in the comments. Alright, back to the new release. You now have 2D support in the add-on, which means when you create a new concept graph object, you need to select either the 2D or the 3D version. This one is not useful and can be ignored. Also, keep in mind that 2D support is very new and I've never made a 2D game before. That means I have no idea what kind of feature would be useful to you, so again, let me know in the comment what you need. If you were already using a previous version of the tool, you don't have anything to do, that part should be backward compatible. Another major change is the support for multithreaded execution. Now when the tool is busy regenerating a complex graph, a spinning wheel appears over here. If for some reason that causes issues on your computer, you can go into the project settings, concept graph, generation, and turn it off here. You probably don't need it, but if you do, it's there. The editor was also greatly improved. First, you'll notice the minimap in the bottom right corner. You can click on it to navigate the graph more easily. You can also turn it off by clicking this button next to the zoom option. The Create Node panel was also improved. All categories are now sorted alphabetically and grouped by purpose. So everything that creates new data is under the Generator tab, and every input are under the Input tabs, and so on. If you don't like this grouping strategy, you can click here to group nodes by type instead. And that means it puts every meshes together, every curves together, and so on. You can select the default value in the project settings. Now, take a look at this node. It has a square-shaped input, which means it can accept multiple connections from different nodes. However, if it's round, it can only accept a single connection at once. Two conditional notes were added. This one simply returns one input or the other based on the condition value, and this one returns one of the three inputs based on the result of this operation. So if A is larger than B, then it returns the first input, and if A is smaller than B, it will return the last one. This is useful if you want to disable some part of the graph, or if you want to have a different result based on certain conditions. Thanks to a new contributor, we now have initial support for heightmap generation. This also brings new features for the noise node. You can now blend them together, so you can get more interesting results, or you can adjust their contrast curve just like you would in an image processing software. Be careful though when using really large texture, because it has a significant impact on performance, but it will only get better from there. With all these changes, there is now 127 nodes in ConceptGraph. Check out the changelogs if you want more details about it. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them down below in the comments. If you want to help the development of this free and open source tool, don't hesitate to report any bugs you may find or contribute to the source code. You can also find my Ko-fi page in the description down below. If you want to hear about new releases or tutorials regarding ConceptGraph, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and have a great day!